Once as I joined as a full-time software engineer at Microsoft, I was on the Azure storage team. And the Azure storage team, by the time I joined it, had a bunch of SDKs that customers were using. We also had a backlog of bugs and features that we wanted to add to those SDKs. And now I was in charge of trying to get that stuff done. Well, the SDKs really had no solid architecture to them. They were just kind of put together by a bunch of programmers. And so adding certain features that customers wanted, such as the ability to report progress when uploading or downloading a blob, a very reasonable feature, the engineers who worked on the SDKs would sometimes tell me it's going to take 6 months of full-time effort just to add that, which seemed ridiculous to me. So as I started to look into it more, I realized that the current architecture that we had for the SDKs was insufficient. We needed something new. So I went to the powers that be and I told them I'd like to re-architect these SDKs and have like a real architecture that's extensible. And they were not opposed to the idea, but they were afraid of how the breaking changes might affect customers on a new architecture that wasn't proven. So they said, please go and pick another programming language for which we don't have an SDK today. And I choose Google's Go language as the one to pick. So I started working on this new architecture in Go, and then it did take off and it was very extensible and good. Other teams at Microsoft saw it and decided to create an Azure SDK team, which all Azure SDKs would now adopt this architecture, and that's how we now have a consistent SDK architecture for all Azure services.